God grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change, the courage to change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we ask for your almighty hand to be upon all of those who are honored today. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and love. Help them to stay true to their dreams, to use their gifts wisely, and to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love. Amen.
Just a little bit of housekeeping. Don't forget to turn off your cell phones for this important event that we have here tonight. Dr. Massey, Board of Directors, Administration, Faculty, Distinguished Business Partners, Honored Students, Loving Family and Friends, and all of our guests here tonight, welcome. We're delighted to have you here to participate and share in the annual Sigma Beta Delta Honor Society induction ceremony at Indian River State College. Thank you for making time to share this evening with us. The fact that many of you have traveled long distances does serve to remind us all of the importance of this event. Honored students, I welcome you to the world of business and I wish you a long and successful career. Of all the people who have gone to college, approximately only 15 out of every 100 will do as well as you have by being admitted into this honor society. So based on this information, I know everyone in this room would agree that this is a tremendous compliment to you and your efforts. The School of Business at Indian River State College wants every student to attain their full potential. In fact, it is our mission to make that possible. We strive to challenge, excite, and inspire you on every step of your education journey. The results of our teaching styles combined with your very, very hard efforts speaks for themselves in the numbers of students that we are honoring here tonight. One of the ways in which we will honor you is through the presentation by an exciting guest speaker. And I'm so pleased to have the opportunity to introduce him to you. He is a native of South Florida. Let's hear it for the Floridians. Yeah, okay, good. That's great. And he holds a position as the regional vice president of Enterprise Holdings, which is the corporate parent of Alamo Enterprise and National Car Rental. As with many organizations of this magnitude, with this gleaming reputation, moving up and receiving promotions is based on superior performance. Therefore, as you can imagine, as the regional vice president, Mr. Nissan is a true standout in his field with an excellent understanding of what it takes to make your mark as you continue on your path of progress from where you are today to your ultimate career goal. He couples this understanding with a remarkable vision of the future, the key elements of superior customer relations, and the ability to not only produce results from yourself, but also to enthusiastically motivate your team to higher and higher achievements. So let's do a little recap of his career. He started his career at Enterprise as a management trainee in 2004. He was promoted to a branch manager 2 years later, then cross-promoted to the remarketing manager in 2007, and then he returned to the car rental side of the business in 2011 as an area manager. Then, through top performance and development of his teams, he was promoted to the area market manager for one of the largest enterprise locations, the Fort Lauderdale Airport. Finally, in May of 2014, Mr. Nissan was promoted to the regional vice president. In addition to applying his talents at Enterprise Holdings, he also demonstrates his knowledge of the importance of community involvement and social responsibility by dedicating some of his personal time to events and activities such as the youth sports coach, amateur athletic union volunteer coach, travel basketball coach for West Boca Basketball, Relay for Life, and Toys for Tots, among others. Finally, all of his coworkers say that he's a fascinating person, so I would guess that means that we're in for a treat tonight. So without further ado, would you please join me in a warm welcome for our guest, Mr. Jason Neeson.
Wow. That sums up my life in about 11 years there. Well, thank you very much for that, and thank you for having me. Good evening, everyone. It's great to be here with you today as we celebrate your induction into Sigma Beta Delta. I am both honored and flattered to have been asked to speak at this wonderful occasion. On behalf of Enterprise, I would first like to congratulate each of you and your families here celebrating with you for being recognized tonight as the top students here at Indian River State College. For years, we have had the privilege of watching bright students such as yourselves begin building their futures at this institution. You were not only chosen for this International Honor Society, not only based on your academic merit, but also your undoubtable leadership skills. You should be incredibly proud to be selected for this recognition. With all the tremendous learning opportunities Indian River State College has for students today, I feel certain you won't forget this experience. College, in general, is a time like no other. When else are you able to explore all that interests you? Of course, this freedom also means you face a lot of choices. And while some will be more difficult than others, I encourage you to have confidence in every decision you make. After all, you've already shown good judgment by deciding to not only attend college, but to excel in your scholastic achievements. Your selection for this society demonstrates you have what it takes to succeed in any course of study or career path you may choose. Wisdom, honor, and aspiration are the core values of Sigma Beta Delta and will lead to a fulfilled and fulfilling life. However, you will ultimately decide to apply your talents. We look forward to seeing you make your mark on this campus and inevitably on the world. Wherever you go and whatever you do, we ask that you make a difference. Make a contribution in your neighborhood, your city, or even the world. Keep learning, keep asking questions, keep looking for answers, and most importantly, keep moving forward. With the same energy and the same ambition that brought you here today. On behalf of the Taylor family and the employees of Enterprise Holdings, good luck not only during your college career, but in all your future pursuits. Congrats to each of you.
I want to thank Mr. Neeson for those inspiring words, and I would like to give him a small token of our appreciation.
Thank you very much.
Sigma Beta Delta, Chapter of Indian River State College, we will now proceed with the induction of newly elected members. Will all of the Honor Society inductees and candidates please rise? Do you desire to be admitted into Sigma Beta Delta? If so, say I do.
I do.
Based on your academic achievements in business, management, and administration, you've been invited to membership in Sigma Beta Delta. We are honored to have you join the society that encourages and recognizes scholarship and accomplishment among students, business, management, and administration, and encourages and promotes aspiration toward personal and professional improvement and a life distinguished by honorable service to humankind. The principles of Sigma Beta Delta are represented by the Greek words with the initials which form our society, Sigma, Beta, and Delta. Hear now what Sigma means to us from Professor Carpenter.
First of all, congratulations on your induction in the Sigma Beta Delta, and I'm here to share with you some of the virtues regarding the Greek letter Sigma. Sigma is the initial letter of the Greek alphabet, or the Greek word Saphia, which means wisdom. Wisdom is the knowledge gained over time, analyzed, and used with discernment. Wisdom is not merely information, but allows one to acknowledge information, consider its validity, its relevance, and then incorporate that into one's own life and what is appropriate. The wise person realizes the importance of continual learning and accepts the challenge to do so and to gain a more complete understanding of new knowledge. Wisdom is knowledge applied. This person seeks to apply knowledge to benefit humankind. As a member of Sigma Beta Delta, I challenge you to pursue wisdom throughout your life. Now I ask Dr. Ricardo to come share the stage to give the virtues of the Greek letter Beta.
Congratulations. Beta is the initial letter of the Greek word babios, which signifies honor. Honor is a personal quality of the highest value. Honorable persons are held in esteem, considered to be trustworthy, and admired by others because they live a life that is worthy of such recognition. Honorable persons have chosen to live a life that is bounded by integrity and ethical decision-making so that they may be free of the tyranny of dishonor. Honorable persons strive to do which is right, even in the face of opposition. Honorable persons respect others and are willing to provide leadership to the benefit of humankind. As a member of Sigma Beta Delta, I challenge you to accept honor as a constant companion throughout your life. And now please listen finally to the explanation of Delta, Professor Pilley.
Congratulations. Delta is the initial letter of the Greek word dioko, which signifies the pursuit of meaningful aspiration. To aspire to worthy goals set apart persons of accomplishment and those who merely mark time with their lives. Persons of wisdom and honor must aspire to a course to achieve their objectives. For goals without actions are no more fulfilling than actions without goals. To aspire towards the fulfillment to one's goals to serve humankind and develop personally and professionally will lead to a life of meaningful and satisfaction. As a member of Sigma Beta Delta, I challenge you to aspire to goals that will chart you on the path of wisdom and honor throughout your life.
Initiates, you have now heard the principles which members of Sigma Beta Delta support and strive to uphold, which are wisdom, honor, and aspiration. Candidates, do you accept these principles as your own? If so, say I do.
I do.
All right. Please repeat after me the following oath. I pledge myself to maintain and uphold. The principles of Sigma Beta Delta.
The principles of Sigma Beta Delta.
International Honor Society in Business.
International Honor Society in Business.
Management and Administration.
Management and Administration.
I will pursue wisdom.
I will pursue wisdom.
I will accept honor.
I will accept honor.
I will aspire to fulfill worthy goals.
I will aspire to fulfill worthy goals.
As a member of this chapter of Sigma Beta Delta.
As a member of this chapter of Sigma Beta Delta.
I will accept my responsibility.
I will accept my responsibility.
To support and encourage its purposes.
To support and encourage its purposes.
I will continually seek.
I will continually seek.
To represent well.
To represent well.
My chapter.
My chapter.
My college.
My college.
And my nation.
And my nation.
Throughout my life.
Throughout my life.
In recognition of your academic achievement and your pledge to the principles of Sigma Beta Delta, we will now present to you the insignia of the society. The insignia provides a tangible symbol of the principles of wisdom, honor, and aspiration which you have just accepted. Thank you, candidates. You may be seated. First row candidates, please make your way to the stage. Brennan Booth. Abigail Orchards. Christina Buse. Isaac Fire. Danielle Calabrese. Robert Carberry. Ayanna Clark. Yamilet Sendejas. Nicole Coble. Kelly Kramer. Linda Cutler. April Dunham. Caitlin Furby. Danielle Gajewski. Michael Iannucci. Amanda James. Kathleen Caddis. Deborah Kelly. Colin Kircher. Erica Martin Alfrey. Kelly Matteson. Jennifer Nezel. Jane O'Brien. Glenda Owens. Sophia Perez. Gabe Ramirez Acosta. Amanda Segarra. Tiffany Smidley. Jonathan Snyder. Chelsea Stewart. Lisa Tamily. Catherine Torres. Marcella Williams. Alisa White. Nicole Winship. Cherry Yu. This concludes the presentation of the candidates. Now, please welcome your chapter student president, Brennan T. Booth, to give the initiation recognition.
Good evening. I began my collegiate career at IRC as a dual enrollment student during my junior year of high school at Lincoln Park Academy. I had been a focused student in regards to my academic studies. However, I was still very unsure of myself and what direction I wanted to go in life. At that same time, I thought that the 2 years for an associate's degree seemed like an eternity and that I did not even want to contemplate a bachelor's degree. Shortly after graduating from high school, I earned my associate's degree from IRSC, and then completing my bachelor's degree became my sole educational goal. At this point in time, I admittedly did not see the true value that I would earn from completing my education. I harbored a skepticism towards my own education. It was not that I believed it was pointless. I knew that completing my bachelor's degree would not hinder any of my goals or potential in life, but I still did not see the true rewards and benefits worth having an education at that point. I worried that I was potentially wasting the time that I was committing to my studies. During the same moment in time that I questioned the benefits of my education, I started a very simple and exceptionally small business. Looking back at the early days of my simple operation, my presentation and understanding of it were very awkward. My business performed paint and metal restoration services, with my area of specialty being Class 6 to 8 commercial vehicles and RVs. Thanks to my studies in the associates program, I knew how simple it was for me to open such a business, a few short filing forms and a few filing fees with the local city and county governments, and I was the proud proprietor of my own business. My education up to that point served me well again when I knew as the sole proprietor I was responsible for all the liabilities of my quaint operation. Bearing this in mind, I purchased liability insurance for my operation to ensure my own security and to reassure any potential customers. It was about that time that I began to work for my first clients, also being in courses in the business administration program here at IRSC. It was during these courses that new topics like culture, perception, and the environments of organizations were injected into the traditional business concepts. Suddenly, my own ignorance had become very clear to me, as I had often wondered why at times my clients and potential customers did not seem to take me seriously. I often attributed this to being so much younger than them in most cases. However, this was not the case at all. Admittedly, I dressed like a kid going to the beach. I did not think to return phone calls in a timely manner, and it never occurred to me that I came across as unprofessional when speaking with my customers. And I now saw it and developed a need to meticulously present myself professionally in all my endeavors. As I was the only employee of my simple operation, I was the face, voice, and culture of my small business. And when I began taking myself seriously, my business began to grow. As my operation expanded, my desire to be a better professional grew with it. And as my revenues indicated, as I became better, so did my business. I had derived my own tangible evidence to support the need for higher education, and I could now see the rewards that committing myself to my studies would yield to me. I no longer held any skepticism towards my own education, and I found that the more I studied the concepts presented in the business administration program, my ability to conduct my operations efficiently grew better with them. Not that I intended to polish paint and metal forever, but I had now found a purpose for myself, and I had determined the direction that I wanted to move in life. I decided that I wanted to broaden my horizons for as long as I lived, and attending college had become an inspiration for me. Eventually, at its peak, my operation grew to service water and aircraft as well. However, the mainstay of my operation would remain the Class 6 to 8 commercial trucks and RVs. I would go on to service over 8 full-time accounts that covered the Treasure Coast and Palm Beach County, and countless seasonal customers as well. All of my dedicated customers would go on to strongly recommend me to new clients. My customers became adamant about my professionalism in all dealings and disputes, regardless of their size. As my studies in the bachelor's program progressed, I developed as a business owner. My ability to communicate with clarity and honesty would become my trademark. I realized that for the first time, I had overcome a lifelong shyness that had defined me until that point. People now recognized me for being direct, not rude, but straightforward and honest. I spoke earlier of perception. I now perceived myself as a business professional, and I began to convey that confidence in all aspects of my life. It is hard for me to describe the rewards I found as I became more motivated by my education. when I was a young individual. I now felt an obligation to my institution, which had been so rewarding to me. I knew that I no longer represented myself and my business, but I was also a representative of IRSC. It was my duty to put forth my best effort, not only for myself, but to the institution that had fostered my development and to the professors who had shared their time, knowledge, and experience to make me a better student. I knew when I first filed for my business license that I would cease my operations, most likely when I graduated. As I entered the summer semesters before my senior year at IRSC, I began to research different career options. Eventually, I began the process of applying to the U.S. Air Force for an officer's commission. This was a painstaking process that involved a lot of time and effort. However, it looked like a great opportunity for me to serve my country and to continue my education. Unfortunately, like most things in life, if the opportunity seems too good to be true, in all likelihood, it is. As time progressed and I neared the end of the application process, it was made clear to me that the careers I was interested in were not and would not be available for some time. While this was occurring, I had taken a part-time position working at night, and I was enrolled in 5 courses, and I was still operating my own business and had nearly bitten off more than I could chew. It was at that time that I decided to scale down and eventually cease my business operations. My business was no longer my primary source of income, and I truly needed to dedicate that time to my studies to ensure that I performed to my potential. While shutting down my business was a hard decision, I do not regret it. I was once again able to commit my full attention to my coursework. It is remarkable how far such a small and simple operation made me grow as a person. The knowledge, experience, and lifelong friendships that I made because I chose to open it still strike me when I reflect on it. It was because of this small business that I became serious about myself and finally realized the benefits of my own education. Even though I no longer conduct my operations, the reputation that I developed within my community continues to serve me in my current capacity at my night job. I now work for one of my former customers who thought of me and hired me when he saw how hard I always strive for excellence and improvement. Looking back, I've come a long way from the naive skeptic that I was when I began dual enrollment, but I have not made it this far alone. I have always had and continue to have the unbelievable support of my parents. My father demonstrated what commitment should be when I was a child and has always been there for me, and my mother continues to be an inspiration to me as she graduated from IRSC with her bachelor's degree in education 2 years ago, taking night classes while working full-time and taking care of her family as well. She set the bar high, but I'm glad she did, as it didn't leave me any room for excuses. Aside from my parents, my grandfather was a profound source of guidance and inspiration during a pivotal point in my life. My grandfather was a man who came from very humble beginnings, but remained driven and committed to education his entire life and always aspired to better himself. He was able to overcome his simple beginnings and become an exceptionally successful salesman and entrepreneur. Even though my grandfather was a salesman, he was a man of very few words. He never said anything he didn't have to. This was a quality that I deeply admired about him, for when he spoke, people listened. When I discussed potentially leaving college, it was at one of these rare instances which my grandfather chose to advise me not to leave. He insisted that even if I did not see the immediate value of my education, I would be ever grateful that I stayed and finished my degree. I have to say that he was right, because I overlooked the trivial 4 years to earn my bachelor's degree and stayed enrolled and committed to my education. I am undoubtedly a better man today. Sadly, my grandfather passed away earlier this year, and while I will forever miss him, I will always be thankful that he chose to counsel me at that point in my life. It is impossible for me to accurately describe to you the support and inspiration that I find from the incredible professors that comprise IRSC's business department. They are an exceptional culmination of knowledge, experience, and talent that fosters creativity and a remarkable learning environment for me and my fellow students. I know I'm a better person today because I had the opportunity to work with and study from professors who instilled in me the desire to achieve and a commitment to continuous improvement. I will be graduating this May, and I already know that it will be bittersweet. I will have finally earned my bachelor's degree, but my time here at IRSC will be coming to an end. While this is the end of one chapter, I find great solace in that this is just the beginning of my education, and it signals to me that it is once again time for progression. I have found a great opportunity to serve our country and to continue my education in the U.S. Coast Guard, and I am anxiously awaiting for my time to take advantage of this great opportunity. Because of my time here at IRSC, I will be a student of education for the rest of my life, and per Dr. Carlson's advice, I will be pursuing at least a couple master's degrees. Good luck to you and all your future endeavors, and thank you for listening to me.
Thank you, Brennan. And now please welcome the Dean of the School of Business, Dr. Cedric Gibson.
Good evening. Actually, it's pretty difficult to follow Brennan's story. I really appreciate you sharing your journey. That was meaningful and it was moving, definitely inspiring. But good evening again. My name is Cedric Gibson. Before I acknowledge the generosity of our sponsors and also to present the scholarships to our awardees, I want to take a second to acknowledge a group of individuals that I have a chance to work with every day, and I very much admire these individuals. And without them, this particular program, this event, would have not been possible. So if the School of Business faculty would please stand, along with the divisional staff members, you'll stand at this moment and just to be recognized, because there were a lot of meetings and just a lot of behind the curtain work that went on that made this possible. So just want to say thank you. Just like Brennan said, I want to second that. They are an awesome team, and I enjoy working with them. So thank you for acknowledging that firsthand. And it's, I think it's really meaningful coming from a student. Basically, what we're going to talk about at this particular point is some of the concepts that we use in business to work with other companies, to work with a lot of individuals in our community to try to enhance our programs. And through those conversations, you will find tonight that we have two IRSC clubs that generously partnered together using some business savviness that they learned in their business classes to come together, to partner, and to be able to present a $500 scholarship to a lucky, and I would say lucky, but also fortunate and deserving member this evening. So if you would, if we have the president or any officers from our Sigma Beta Delta, as well as our investment club, if you would please stand at this time and just be recognized for your contribution. The first recipient of the sponsorship from Enterprise, and kind of like get a drum roll, although I don't have a drum, sorry. The first unfortunate recipient is Linda Cutler.
This is real stuff. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Linda. Congratulations. The second recipient, another drum roll, is Catherine Torres. We have one more scholarship, our third and final scholarship of the evening. And at this time, I would like to invite the Sigma Beta Delta president, Mr. Brennan Booth, to the stage. Investment Club president, Tuk Do, and Investment Club vice president, John Snyder, to the stage to join Dr. Massey and Mrs. Becker. These two clubs, as I said earlier, they partnered together to be able to bring the opportunity to our lucky recipient to be able to earn a $500 scholarship. So another drum roll for the recipient of this scholarship is Mrs. Jennifer Nezel.
Congratulations, Jenna.
All right, that concludes our scholarship presentations. Gentlemen, thank you very much. At this time, I would like to thank Dr. Massey, Mrs. Decker, Enterprise Holding, Sigma Beta Delta, and the Investment Club for their time and financial support, as well as congratulate the three scholarship recipients. Dr. Carlson is going to come to the stage at this time to deliver the closing statement, and Dr. Carlson is our Vice President of Sigma Beta Delta, as well as the advisor for the Investment Club. Dr. Carlson?
Thank you, Dean Gibson, for the introduction. I just got my 9 pages of closing remarks out, so this shouldn't take very long, but it'll be interesting. Well, we have reached the conclusion of the 2015 induction ceremony, and inductees, you are now members of the Honor Society. Congratulations. But I'd like to thank the family and friends who have turned up and turned out to join you in celebrating this achievement, because it is quite an achievement. Academically, the inductees represent the top 13% of the bachelor students in the School of Business. That's a great accomplishment. Great. So, let me now refer to the things that we expect from you. We do expect you to be the leaders of business and community and state and nation. But we'd also ask you to be leaders on a broader basis and on a global basis, so that you can impact even greater and more people in the world. Take a global approach. This is your future, and this is what we demand of you. So thank you. Now, I would like to conclude the ceremony. There's refreshments and food in the rear, so please. But we have one final thing that we need to do. Members of the Honor Society, we would like you to come to the stage for one group photo, if you would mind, please.